Good evening. Sydney is preparing to take its next major step in reopening as almost all students return to classes tomorrow after months of home learning. And with COVID cases still forcing schools to close for cleaning, the Education Minister has told Nine News rapid antigen testing for younger students is something that is being considered.
In Mount Druitt, school shoes are being polished and the bags are being packed, but as for going back to class, the feelings are mixed.
Not excited at all.
I'm excited because I can see my best friends and I can see all the teachers.
Students in kindergarten year 1 and year 12 went back to class last Monday, the date brought forward for all other years. Mum Ayla Ardle is happy about it with some trepidation.
Don't want the kids to get COVID, really. I will be sending them to school with masks, so then they've at least got some sort of protection. Whether or not they wear it, I don't know.
That trepidation heightened by COVID-positive cases closing around 40 schools across the state for deep cleaning just a week after reopening. The Education Minister understands the anxiety but says COVID safety measures will reduce the risks and minimise disruption.
By keeping children in individual class groups as well and having our staff vaccinated, what we're finding is there's much fewer close contacts, much less disruption to school communities.
New South Wales is also considering rapid antigen testing for students who are close contacts to get them back to class sooner, particularly in primary years.
Few would have felt the pressures of this year more than our Year 12 students. The HSC was due to begin on October 12. And they've only just gone back to class in the last week to face a delayed HSC on November 9.
Stressful at the best of times, but new research for DrinkWise has found 58% of Year 12s are feeling anxious about their mental health, up from 41% last year. Just 41% report feeling good about their lives, down from 52%. But female students are faring worse, 71% worried about their mental health, just 34% feeling good. Concerned they're turning to drugs and alcohol, DrinkWise has relaunched its You Got This campaign, with well-known Australians offering messages of support.
If you're having any difficulty or trouble, make sure you talk to your family, talk to your friends. We all need it at this time. Have fun, be safe, and best of luck.
So all the best, and remember, you got this.
Our message to Year 12 students is, you got this. Please stay strong, positive and resilient. And remember that one year doesn't define the rest of your life.
Eddie Meyer, Nine News.
The biggest campaign of its kind in more than a decade has been unveiled, aiming to resuscitate tourism in New South Wales. But rather than highlight some old icons, the bridge and the Opera House, it's been decided to showcase the state's many other attractions and its people.
It was a tough brief. Sell New South Wales to the rest of Australia and to the world in 60 seconds.
It really encapsulates the beauty and the experiences that New South Wales has to offer.
Welcome to New South Wales. A place to feel alive, to feel free, and most of all, to feel new again.
The state has been losing $1.6 million a week in lockdown. This is a campaign to bring the tourism industry back from the brink, just as regional and overseas travel resumes in 8 days.
We want to feel new. We want to feel refreshed. We want to feel re-energised. And that's exactly what this campaign does.
A big part of this campaign is to go beyond the bridge and the Opera House, to take interstate and overseas visitors into the bush. That way, the billions spent on tourism will be spread around New South Wales.
We don't want people just to come down to Circular Quay here and look left at the bridge and right at the Opera House and straight ahead at the harbour and think they've done Sydney and get on a plane and fly home and feel like, well, I don't need to go back.
And a new campaign from the federal government urging vaccine stragglers to get the jab.
We're almost there, Australia.
86.6% of the country has had its first dose. 73% are fully vaccinated. Now the final push for the rest.
We've now got enough vaccines distributed around the country to fully vaccinate, double dose, all Australians who want to get vaccinated.
New South Wales case figures dip below 300, 296 with 4 deaths. 93% of over 16s have now had one dose. 84.8% are fully vaccinated. Compare that to Queensland,
60% double dose, and WA at 59%. Mark Burrows, Nine News.